button followed by the hot water. Then you will get the temperature.
Yeah.
This is the temperature for the group. We can increase in steps of 0.1 or make less if we need 93 or we need maybe 92.5.
Temperature 1 is temperature in the big world.
Yeah. Here. Ah. The brewing temperature.
Brewing temperature, okay.
Yeah. Then you can go for the cup warmer.
Okay.
You can switch it on or off. In the meantime, let it be off and how much degrees you need
for the
cup warmer. So you can put 51. Depends on the ambient temperature.
Yeah. It's cold too much.
Yes. Then you have the pre-infusion. This is a pre-brewing. You can switch it on or off.
And it's automatically on 3.5 bar or 3?
You can. This one is automatically at 3.
Yeah, 3. Yeah.
Exactly. So you can switch it on. You can set the pre-infusion 1 for those one. You can increase. Maybe it depends on the roast of your coffee beans. You can set pre-infusion 2. This is the dose number 2. Pre-infusion 3. Double press, you get dose number 3. Double press, dose number 4. Now you can set the pre-infusion for dose 4 maybe. Let's say 4 seconds. 3.5. Depends on. Also, when you make the coffee, you can tell.
So opening program 1, it's 1 press, program 2.
Exactly.
1 press, program 3. Double press, program 4, double press.
So, then you'll go for the dosing.
Yeah.
This amount of water is the quantity of water that the brew water.
Yeah.
If we add the coffee, some water will go to?
You don't retain in the coffee.
Yeah.
Yeah. So you need to increase. If you need 40, 50 ml of water for the coffee, you need to add a little bit more.
Exactly.
Because it will stay in the. It's okay, they will find the numbers in practice.
Then
once they learn the numbers, they will remember them.
Mm-hmm. Then the continuous dose also is?
Yeah, how much can be maximum?
The maximum is
it's
500.
500, yeah.
The problem with it, once you go to 500, then you have to.
Okay. I shouldn't ask. Can you hold it now?
No.
Oh my
that
God.
Is one thing I asked them. Why don't you make something we can just press and hold
yeah.
Other than going one by one by one? They are talking about precision, accuracy.
Leave it to 100 plus if you get it. We need it, yeah, continuous manual, huh?
Yeah, manual.
And for that we just need to press middle button.
Exactly.
But to save?
So here we go.
Just go to the main, all end of the menu and save, yeah.
Let's
see. Yeah, it's enough.
And once you press?
It's saved.
It's saved.
Yeah,
and
that
so is?
And program. So just to mm-hmm. be precise. This is program 1. And it will start. I don't know how much we set up, but let it stop. Okay,
second.
This is program 2. And it will stop. How much we program in the program? Okay, double press. Mm-hmm. So, this is program 3. Now it's program 3.
Yeah.
That's how you know it's program 3. Okay. Need to blink. Same for program 4. And it's 4 programs. So when you see on programming, pre-infusion P1, program 1, P2, program 2. It's the same for the mLs, P1, P2, P3, P4. So if you want to use program 4, you need to press double here. Program
and the other double
here.
Is double
yeah.
Program.
So that's it.
At 3.
And this group is dependent of this
yeah.
one. If you set this one, then you have to jump and set this.
Same parameters there, if you want the same parameters.
Okay. Currently we are doing at 7.9, that is 8.
So we need to
this one you need to.
Here and here.
This button followed by continuous followed by the second dose. Okay. Then I long press the center button on the continuous press button. This is now where we go for the main settings. My password will be this. But be careful when you are changing there. I prefer you don't change.
Yeah, don't it just
only go for the temperature if you need. We'll set it once, don't worry.
For opening and closing.
So they'll go for dosage setting. In this menu you can do the dosage setting.
Bro?
Yeah. It will be set always.
Automatically.
It will be automatic. So
yeah, it's when you enter come to the end of the menu, it's already set.
Exactly.
When
And once 31 is 31 every day.
For example, now I'm grinding and I want to calibrate manual. I keep on testing which button that I have to go.
There is one option.
Yeah.
You set 31 and check how much you have in the cup. If it's less, then you increase.
You need to go there. Ah, okay. Then I increase. Yeah.
The two options for the calibration are, if you have good experience about maybe 20 grams, you give me around this with this ml. If that option does not work for you well, then I prefer you go for long press this button.
And then calibrate manually.
Yeah, and check you how much.
The calibration manually. And I will go for?
Until, let's say 40 or something.
Let's say stop at 54, because now you'll be checking the weight.
Exactly. Yeah.
So once I finish on 54, I'll wait for at least 30 seconds. The blinking to stop. If you're in a hurry, you can switch off and on.
Yeah.
But 30 seconds is not too much to wait. So the blinking has stopped. So I set this one at 54. Now I can check it again.
You can save it like that. Amazing.
You can save fast by...
But you can also... It's
now we're at 4. And note, we have the pre-infusion period. It doesn't affect the quantity. Once you set it manually, it will be the same quantity. So you can play, let's say I've put my... Then you can set it manually and then you don't have to go for D1, D2, D3.
Yeah, also.